Hi, N.A., Jason William Michener Galbraith, G-A-O-M-G. Just came back from following up with my doctor with my AFib, and I got great news that I'm out of AFib, that the surgery was successful. It was an arterial fibrillation, ablation, where they went inside my groin, and they go into my heart, and they pretty much try to make it stop from being an AFib. And AFib is these electrical currents that go through your heart, and they can make you have a stroke or a heart attack. And the AFib I had was very severe. My entire heart had the electricity going through it. And I mean, I had like weeks, month, maybe a year to be here. And you know, my doctor was able to basically add 50 years to my life. He said that I'm his model patient. Both my cancer doctor and my AFib doctor both said, they looked at me, you know, for surgery, everything, I'm just standing there naked, and they're like, you are a physical specimen. If anybody can beat cancer, it's you. And if anybody can beat AFib, it's you. So my doctor also uses me as his model patient, because he has other patients that suffer from AFib, and they can't even get out of bed. So he tells them about me that ran the LA Marathon with AFib. I also ran it with my 10th book, my second trilogy, and my ancestral Galbraith tartan that my biological mother never told me about, denied my ancestry, everything about me. So that was definitely one of the greatest feats of my life. And then the other one is the whole cancer story and beating that. I mean, the cancer that I had was that it went from level three cancer to level four. So anybody that knows anything about cancer, that's pretty severe, and I would have died. Both doctors, if they didn't save my life with cancer, and with AFib, I wouldn't be here anymore. So with being able to beat cancer and now AFib, I said I want to be here till 2076. And my doctor said, you keep yourself in this physical specimen that you are, that should be absolutely achievable. And by that time, there might be more positive things in medical stuff that I could go even longer. So I'm very happy to have another 50 years, you know, barring any tragic event or anything, happened to be in my life. And with the electricity, I told my doctor that I also get electricity in my brains when I'm writing. I've talked about it before, that you become clairvoyant when you're writing, and then electricity hits your brain too when you're writing. And when I came up with, you know, the greatest times of difficulty create the greatest people of the times. My generation is the greatest generation of the 21st century, and I'm the greatest author of my generation. All of that hit me with electricity in my brain, and I knew to write down exactly what I was feeling going on in my brain. And that's what I told my doctors. It's just the electricity that usually I get my brain to write with went to my heart by mistake. So anyway, they got a lot of the electricity out of my heart, and we'll just keep it in my brain, and you know, who knows where that'll take me. I'm just very happy to be here. And the other thing I told my doctor is, when I came out of surgery, is I felt the finality of death on my left side and life on my right side. And I saw death leave me and life begin. And I started crying because it was a very emotional time. And I felt like that dude Wesley on Princess Bride, when he's getting tortured and he starts crying, because one is like what I just went through. I thought it was a very like spiritual heavy moment. And then also, I don't want my body mutilated anymore. I'm like cancer and AFib going into my heart and cutting my groin open and cutting out my lymph nodes that could affect me forever. You know, all my doctor says, you must have been on some really good, the narcotics, ketamine or ketamine or something like that, to have seen all of those things. But it was a very powerful moment for me.
and I'm very happy to be here next 50 years. Oh my God. And I have so much planned. I have a big 50 and 50. I get 50 more years and I'm gonna be turning 50. I'll have my 10th book, Bring It to Scotland, a whole bunch of stuff. Everything has just become clear and beautiful. And you know, this is a whole documentary on my life. So cheers. Oh, and support, you could like, whatever, go on my, not OnlyFans, I have a GoFundMe. And you can like donate. I gotta go to Scotland with millions of dollars to buy all the castles. Cheers.